This is a mindfulness for sleeping practice. So hopefully you've listened to the preamble and you've set up the room and your space, you've prepared yourself for sleep and you're feeling relaxed. You're dressed warmly or comfortably. The lights are out, and if you're sharing the house with anybody, they know that you're going to bed. You may even have put a do not disturb sign on your door. So let's just begin by checking, are you comfortable at the moment? Do you have enough pillows? Do you need to remove one pillow, or do you need to adjust it so that your head and your neck are supported properly? So just check that you're comfortable. At first, it'll take a little while to get into the habit of making yourself comfortable, but soon it will become just your habit to set yourself up comfortably for a good night's sleep. Maybe you're more comfortable sleeping on your right or your left side, maybe on your back. If you're sleeping on your back, maybe just try what would it be like if you had a couple of cushions or pillows under your knees. If you live with back pain or joint pain, then sometimes just having your knees a little bit flexed can take the pressure off your back. Similarly, if you sleep on your side, maybe getting a pillow or two and putting them between your knees, supporting your upper leg. And that just keeps your spine nicely aligned as you lie there resting. Just check, are you too warm or too cold? Are you just right? And if you need to put your hands or your feet sticking out from under the covers, or if you need to pull them in, again, just keep making those little checks, so that you don't get disturbed by suddenly feeling too hot or too cold and having to throw off the covers or go and get a couple of extra blankets. I'm going to lead this practice as if you're lying on your back. So just make any little amendments or adjustments to the instructions that I give as we go along if you're in a different posture. Maybe you're listening to this sitting in a chair, or you're on a plane, or who knows. But you'll be able to just take these instructions and apply them to whatever posture you've chosen. Okay. So once you've got yourself all sorted out and you're comfortable, I want you to just, if you're able to, scan your body and see if there's any tension or discomfort anywhere. A lot of us tend to hold tension in parts of our body. For some people, that tension is in their shoulders. For some, elsewhere. So just go to where the usual place is. Notice if there's any tightness in your shoulders. If your shoulders are quite close up by your ears, or if there's any holding. And with your next breath out, I want you to see if you can release your shoulders. Let your shoulders just drop down. Let gravity take your shoulders back towards the mattress. Or maybe even walk your fingers away from you, down towards your knees. And if you notice them creeping back up again, then just bringing them gently back down along your body. If you have a tendency to grind your teeth or clench your jaws, then just waggle your lower jaw. Maybe open your mouth or have a big yawn. Maybe even stick out your tongue as far as you can. All those muscles that are involved in tightly clenching the jaws, softly letting them go. Really deliberately choosing to have your upper and lower jaws apart. You can still have your lips softly closed, but your teeth apart. Notice if there's any expression on your face. Are you frowning to yourself? Is there a furrow in your brow? And just imagine that smoothing itself out. Let your face be without an expression, or if there has to be an expression, maybe just softly curl up the corners of your mouth into a little smile. Difficult to clench your teeth when you're smiling a little bit. And just notice then, as you relax those areas of tension around your head and your neck and your shoulders, if there's a kind of a ripple effect of that. When your jaws aren't clenching and your tongue isn't pushed up against the roof of your mouth or the sides of your teeth, can you feel your face softening a little bit? And then just scan your arms. Are you holding your arms tightly by your sides? Are your fingers tightly gripping each other? Or are they clenched into fists? And just spread out your fingers and then relax. Let your hands rest softly by your sides or on your belly, whichever is more comfortable for you. And if you're able to put your hands a little bit away from your body, a few inches away from your body, palms facing upwards, see if that has an effect of loosening any tension in your shoulders a little bit more. And then just check your belly. So a lot of us hold tension in our bellies. Across our front, we suck in our gut. So a way to just check that is to push your tummy out. Just use those muscles to push your tummy out and then just let your tummy drop. And you can blow out as you do that. And notice if that softens the belly. And just breathe in and out, noticing the belly swelling and subsiding. If that's happening with ease, and if it's happening a little bit more easily, now that you've just checked, are you holding any effort there in your tummy? Scan a little bit further down, this time in your lower back and your buttocks. And just notice if those muscles are tense or tight. It's quite a common area for tall people to hold tension and for people who have chronic back pain or sciatica. They kind of tighten those muscles, thinking that that's going to prevent injury or support them. That can become quite habitual. And actually, it can cause tension in all of the areas around the body, down in the hips, down in the thighs. So just notice if there's any effort there. And if you can't tell, then really clench the muscles, really clench your buttocks, clench the muscles around the thighs, and then let them go. And just notice then the way those muscles relax, how they flatten out a little bit more on the mattress. And similarly, just take a moment to scan your legs. Notice if your legs are tightly held together. If there's any tension in your thighs or if there's any pressure between your knees, and see if you can comfortably lie with your feet hip width apart, letting your feet just flop out to the sides if that's comfortable. And then just scan yourself again, noticing if there's any effort anywhere, if there's any frown, if the shoulders have crept back up, if you're fidgeting with something, just seeing if you can let go of all of that. So let's begin. And remember, if at any point during this guidance you feel the need to move, you need to change your position, you need to adjust something, please do that. Don't feel that you have to wait until the end of this recording to do anything, or that you have to lie perfectly still. All of our practice of mindfulness is paying attention, noticing what we're feeling in our body, responding to it with kindness. So if there's pain or discomfort, if you suddenly start to cramp somewhere, whatever it might be. Yeah, so if you have a little child somewhere in the building, or an animal, if you need to press pause, by all means do that. And then come back. We can just start again. Okay. So I want you to bring your attention to the very top of your head, the crown of your head, just noticing what you can feel there. You might be able to feel a little breeze in the room touching the skin of your scalp or lifting strands of hair. Maybe you can feel the headboard or a pillow. Maybe as your attention goes there, you're able to notice a sound of your pulse. So just noticing that. Noticing what your mind does when you become aware of the sound of your heart beating, or any other sound that you become aware of inside your body, inside this room, inside the building or outside. Often, thoughts are the distractions from sleep, the things that keep us wide awake. So during this practice, whenever you notice your mind jumping in with the "what's that?" or identifying something or being distracted and going somewhere else, just notice that your mind has joined in, that it's distracted or trying to get your attention. Think of that as a gold star moment. You've just had a moment of mindfulness. You've noticed what your mind is doing, and you're choosing to respond to that thought by bringing it back to this voice, this recording. You may have to do that every couple of minutes, and that's absolutely fine. It's perfectly normal. Noticing if your head feels warm there at the top, at your crown. Noticing maybe even if you can feel the contact point between your head and the pillow, a little bit lower down. Maybe you can feel the texture of the pillowcase. And within that pillowcase, maybe you can even feel if there are feathers or foam, if there's soft or firm filling there supporting your head, if it's cool or if it's warm. Maybe noticing if you can feel the pillow touching one or both ears there at the back. Or again, maybe there's some little movement of air in the room, and you can feel that air lightly touching the skin of your ear on the right side or the left side. Noticing if you can feel strands of hair around your ears, there at the top or the back or at the front. Maybe noticing where else can you feel hair on your head. If you don't have any hair, then you don't need to worry about this part. But if you do, maybe noticing any little strands of hair just there across the hairline at your forehead or at your temples, touching the skin. And just noticing if the skin of the forehead is smooth, if there's a little furrow. Sometimes when our brows are furrowed, we're thinking about something, we're concentrating. So just noticing if that's the case, if your mind is on some level thinking about some activity in the day or anticipating something that's happening tomorrow. And if that's the case for you, just gently noticing the mind doing that, and really deliberately choosing to focus all of your attention on the guidance in this practice. Notice if your eyebrows are in their usual soft curve, or if they're raised or lowered. And again, if that's the case, then there's a little bit of effort there, isn't there? So just maybe notice, what's that effort about? Some thought, some sensation of discomfort, maybe. And if there is some discomfort somewhere that keeps tugging your attention away, then just allow your attention to go to wherever that is in your experience. So if there's a physical pain or discomfort somewhere, just gently allowing your attention to go to that part of the body. Notice what's there. What are the sensations there? Is there a burning or an ache? Is there a stabbing? Is there a coldness? Or a shaking? And I want you to turn your attention towards that part of your body with real kindness. Maybe this is a sensation you're very familiar with that often irritates you or brings up a whole train of thoughts about the effect of this discomfort. Just for the duration of this practice, I want you instead to imagine your breath flowing to that part of your body. See if you can soften towards that part of your body. Noticing if there's tension there, trying to hold it or splint it in some way. And just allow the muscles there to be soft, if that's okay. As you breathe in, that air that you're breathing is laden with oxygen. And that breath that flows into your body, into your lungs, is pumped by your heart to that part of the body where there's pain. So imagine that hot, oxygenated blood going to that part of your body where there's pain and flushing it with hot, oxygenated, nutrient-laden blood, plumping up the cells, warming up the muscles. As you soften around that area, the blood flow increases. Waste materials are carried away, just allowing us to become even softer around that part of the body. So just be with that for a little while, kindly, in the same way that you'd kindly be with your friend or your loved one if they had some pain or discomfort. Be patient with yourself. Be interested in yourself. Be kind to yourself. And then gently bring your attention back up to the face. Noticing if there's any tension around the eyelids or the eyes. See if you can let your eyes be soft. While your attention is there, maybe you're noticing that there's some awareness of light or color. That's okay, that's perfectly normal. Maybe your eyes feel a little bit dry, or there's some itchiness or discomfort there. So if that's the case, feel free to blink your eyes. Or maybe next time, use a couple of drops so that your eyes are nice and moist. Or if it's too bright in the room, maybe you can use an eye mask next time. If there's a source of light somewhere in the room, Maybe you need to switch that off. If it's distracting you or keeping you quite wakeful, if there's a little light from a device, a phone, or something else in the room. And once that's done, letting your eyes be softly closed. And then let your attention gently come down to the cheekbones. It's kind of a wide expanse of skin here on the face, isn't there? From under the eyes, the cheekbones, all the way down to the jawline, and either side of the nose and the mouth. So just notice if there's any tension there. If your jaws are clenched, if your tongue is pushed up against the roof of your mouth, then those muscles of your cheeks will also be making some effort. So again, maybe you can give a big yawn. Or if you want, you can really scrunch up your face. Tighten up all of the muscles of the forehead, the eyes, the nose, the mouth. Nobody's looking at you. Doesn't matter what this looks like. Just hold it for a couple of seconds and then let it go. Notice the difference, the softness in those muscles. Not just on the outside, but on the inside of the face. And as you breathe in and out, notice where the air is entering the body. Is it through one or both nostrils? Or through your mouth? Notice if that air feels cool or dry, cold or warm, maybe even humid. Notice what that feels like as it enters your body. Can you feel that movement of air as it flows inwards on the in-breath? And really rest your attention there on that part of your body. You might even notice that there's a sound of your inhaled breath flowing into the body. You might particularly notice this if you're a little bit blocked in your nose, or if you've a bit of a cold or something like that going on. But notice the speed that air is moving at. So notice the sensation of the air going up through the nose into the airways. Goes up through the nostrils into the head. Then it passes down into the airways. You might even be able to feel it there, just touching the very back of your tongue. Or if you're breathing through your mouth, maybe you can feel the air pass by your lips and across the top of your tongue. Just notice what that sensation feels like. And then notice maybe where you stop feeling it. Somewhere there in the middle of the neck. It's probably different for everybody. And if there are any sounds anywhere inside the room, inside the house, or outside the building, just notice that you've noticed that sound. Try not to let your thoughts be pulled away to it, just gently bringing your thoughts back again and again, as often as you need to. noticing the mind's tendency to be distracted, and just always choosing to come back to this moment, using these sensations as an anchor to this moment. If you can feel that your tongue is soft, noticing your tongue there inside the mouth, noticing maybe that it's touching the front teeth, the teeth at the sides, that it's also there at the back of the mouth, and when we swallow, that there's movement in the tongue, not just in the mouth, but a kind of a ripple that goes all the way down our neck. So if you swallow, just notice what that feels like. And if you find it difficult to let your tongue be soft, then a good practice to try is to just let the tip of your tongue gently sit, resting against the back of your upper front teeth. They're just at the front of your palate, really. And just notice how that softens the muscles in the mouth and down along the neck. As our tongue is a muscle and the root of it is in the neck. So when the tongue is tight or tense, a lot of the other structures around it are also tight or tense. So it's a good practice to notice what your tongue is doing, if it's flat against the top of the mouth or against the teeth. And you just let that go. Let that be a little flag to you. The rest of the face, all the other muscles around the cheeks, scalp, the back of the neck, all soften when our tongue is soft. And now just allow your attention to move a little bit further down into your neck, this column connecting your head to your torso. At the moment, whether you're lying on your back or lying on your side, your head is supported by a pillow. So unlike during the day, when your neck is carrying the heavy weight of the head and keeping it poised, upright, and turning it from left to right or nodding it, at the moment, the neck is at rest, the weight of the head being supported by the pillows or the mattress. So just notice what that's like. Now that that part of the body is not having to do so much hard work, maybe you can feel, again, the texture of the pillow under your neck, or maybe you can feel your hair touching the nape of your neck or the back of your neck. Whatever your night clothes are, maybe there's a collar or a neckline and you can feel that touching the base of the neck. Maybe you're wearing jewelry. Just noticing any of those sensations. Maybe you're more aware of the sensation there at the back of your neck than at the front. and some parts of your neck probably are exposed to air. Or maybe you're snuggled right up into the quilt or whatever bedding you're using and your neck is feeling the texture of the sheet or the quilt cover. Just noticing that. There may be a couple of textures at the back and at the front or at the sides of your neck. Different fabric, synthetic, natural. Just letting your attention notice those sensations against the skin of your neck. And as you're lying there, with your attention there in your neck, maybe your awareness is also noticing the movement at the top of your torso being caused by the breath as it flows in and out of your body. Sometimes we think of all of these different parts of the body as being separate to each other when in fact they're all interconnected. So the skin and the muscles of the neck are all connected to the muscles and the skin and the skeleton there at the top of the body. The bones of the spine in your neck carrying on down into the bones of the spine in your chest. At the front, your rib cage, the top of your torso going out to your shoulders, so just begin to allow your attention to flow down there into the top of your torso. Noticing the weight of the body on the mattress. That although you're lying there quite still, in fact, the body is gently moving constantly in time with the breath, rising and falling with every inhalation and exhalation. As we're breathing in, that air we're inhaling flows down into our lungs, inflating those lungs, and the rib cage expands, not just at the front, but at the sides and at the back, causing the entire torso to broaden, widen, and expand on the in-breath. And as we exhale, the lungs emptying and the rib cage returning to its restful position. So just notice that there at the top of your body, at the front, the movement of your collarbones and your breastbone, all of those ribs at the front rising, spreading out and dropping back on the in and the out breath. And not just there, but there under your arms, in your armpits, along the sides of your chest. Notice as you breathe in there the movement along the sides of your body on the left side and the right side. And then let your attention go to the back of your torso, the back of your chest there. As you breathe in, noticing the shoulder blades, their movement as we breathe in, going up and out. The rib cage, each of those pairs of ribs moving apart as the air comes in and inflates the lungs and then dropping back closer together as we exhale. Those different bones in the skeleton moving, and not just the bones, but the muscles around them and the skin around them, all moving as we breathe in and out. Just noticing how you can become aware of those movements, not just on the outside of the body moving within our clothes or the body moving within the bedding. But we can also feel those movements on the inside. Our attention is like a spotlight, and once it rests somewhere, it begins to become more and more aware of different details. And every time we do this practice, every time we breathe in a breath, it'll be different. At different seasons, different times of day, depending on how tired we are or how deep the breath is, every breath is different. If you have a bit of a cold, it'll be different to when you're really well. So every breath is a new breath, a new experience. That's interesting, isn't it? Noticing what that feels like as we breathe in this breath. Noticing how high the breastbone rises or the ribs expand. And maybe as your attention rests there, you also begin to notice the heart beating. This heart that's pumping around all that oxygen that you're breathing in. You might be able to feel that now, right there in the center of your chest, slow and steady. A little bit to the left of center. And you may notice that echo of the heartbeat in different parts of the body as we do this practice. It's funny, isn't it, how sometimes we notice something and think, I've never noticed that before. And yet, we've been breathing and this heart has been beating ever since we were born. Happens with or without our attention. And just let your attention now flow all the way down to the end of the rib cage. We have 12 pairs of ribs, and they kind of flare out there down towards the end of the rib cage. See if you can feel that movement there towards the bottom of the chest, coming down into the abdomen. Those ribs curving around from the bottom of the breastbone, around to your waist, all the way around to your back, where they meet at the spine. Each one of those pairs of ribs is connected to one of the bones in your spine. So the spine is being massaged by the breath. And if the spine is being massaged, then so is the spinal cord and the fluid that it bathes in. This breath rocking the entire body. So this breath rocking, gently moving every structure inside the body, inside the bones, inside the spaces, gently rocking the organs within the chest and below the diaphragm. When we breathe in, that muscle, that flat sheath called the diaphragm, flattens out all the way across the body from the spine to the front of the chest. It flattens out and everything underneath it is gently pushed down and away. So all of those ligaments and muscles and organs that occupy the abdomen, gently flowing backwards and forwards, up and down, on that tidal movement of the breath. If your hands are resting on your tummy, then you'll be able to feel that movement, the rise and fall. If you're wearing pajamas, maybe if your pajama bottoms have a waistband, you can feel a little bit of constriction and release on the in and the out breath. Or in some other way, feel the body moving within the bed, within the pajamas or the night clothes. Whatever you're wearing. Maybe you can feel a little bit of friction or the weight of the quilt or the duvet or whatever bedding is on top of you as the body moves with the breath. Bring your attention right back inside your body, feeling that movement, that rocking movement caused by the breath. Not just at the front of the belly, but also at the sides, at your waist. Can you feel the expansion there at the sides? Maybe you can even feel your arms being pushed gently away as the body expands on the in-breath. You might feel that through your shoulders or the insides of your upper arms or your elbows, the parts of your arms that are resting against your body. like an echo of the breath. Although the weight of the body is keeping us still on the mattress, actually the skeleton and the muscles and the organs are moving within that. Like another echo of the breath, might be able to feel a little bit of ebb and flow like movement in your elbows, that little pressure point of the body on either side. Or in your hands, whether they're at your side or resting on your belly, maybe you can feel a little echo of the breath, a rising and a falling, or maybe even a pulse, that other indication of the breath flowing all around the body, all the way down into the wrists and the palms, into the fingers, right to the very tips. Noticing if the hands feel warm or cold or neutral wherever they are. And noticing how, if your attention is in your hands, how much more aware you are of any pulsing or throbbing, tingling or warmth that you can feel there in the front or the back of your hands. Feel the weight of them wherever they're resting, and how in other parts of the hands or the fingers maybe you can feel the touch of air against the skin. Letting your attention flow up along the forearms, into the elbows. Noticing if they're flexed or straight. Letting go of any effort if you notice any tension or holding there. Letting your attention flow all the way up your arms, through those muscles. All the way up into the shoulder joints. Those two ball and socket joints on the left side and the right side. The shoulder blades and the collarbones. Enveloping the top of your upper arm, your humerus. How those joints move up and down on the in and the out breath. Notice that your attention tends to be at the front of the body, the front of your shoulders, the front of your arms, the front of the torso, the chest and the belly. But just allow yourself to notice the back of the shoulders, all the muscles, the skin, the back of the rib cage and the spine, all the way down into the back of your pelvis, and into your buttocks. That long expanse of bones and muscles that protect the soft organs inside the torso. Just noticing the weight there, evenly distributed along the length of the body. With each breath out, letting go a little bit more, a little bit more, sinking into the mattress, letting gravity hold us there. Might be able to feel the pressure point where the weight of your lower body is resting against the mattress, just there through that kind of wedge-shaped bone of the sacrum at the bottom of the spine, just above your tailbone. The rest of the pelvis out to the sides, curving around and at the front, coming down into a kind of a V there at the pubic bone. Just noticing any echo of that rocking movement that you're aware of in the muscles around the abdomen or the back, there at the front of the belly, below your belly button, or even inside, noticing there in the pelvic floor any sensation of movement connected with the breath. And then letting your attention flow down into the hips and the upper legs, noticing the connection between the muscles and the joints, inside and outside, the skin surrounding us, going down from the abdomen and the groin, at the front and from the buttocks and the back, the sides of the hips, into the thighs on the left and the right side. These are joints and muscles that are usually weight-bearing. And lying here, they're not having to do anything, just resting. So just noticing what that feels like. Those muscles just resting there at ease. The mattress underneath them, the bedding above them. Maybe you can feel your legs touching each other, or maybe there's a cushion between them or underneath them. Just noticing the textures, if the joints are straight or flexed. Let your attention flow all the way down to the knees, noticing if those two joints are at ease, if they're flexed, if they're supported by something keeping them gently at rest and open. And if there's any discomfort in either of those joints, in your knees or your hips, just imagine this breath being a cool, gentle salve. That movement of the breath, flushing them, bringing them oxygen and nutrients and flushing away anything that causes discomfort. Softening towards them, even if they're sometimes a source of pain. Just accepting that sometimes that's the case. But for now, they don't have to do anything. Don't have to walk or stand or bend or kneel or go anywhere. Noticing if, as your attention flows down your lower legs, past your calves and your shins, if you can feel a pulse or any other sensation on either leg as your attention moves all the way down into the ankles. So if you can feel the weight of your lower legs through your heels or your ankles, just noticing those contact points where the weight of your body is resting on the mattress or the cushion. And if you need to move, if there's any discomfort, just shifting them a little bit. Noticing if you can feel any sensations down there. Those far away parts of the body, our feet, on the left side or the right side. All those bones in the feet, muscles and ligaments. When we're standing or walking, the entire weight of the body goes from one foot to the other. Hardest working parts of the body. And at the moment, they don't have to do anything. How do they feel? Are they warm or cold? Neutral? Maybe you're wearing snuggly, soft socks. Maybe they're hanging out over the end of the mattress in the cool air. Maybe you can feel the weight of the quilt or the texture of the fabric touching the skin of your feet. Maybe you can feel your pulse throbbing through the arches of the feet or there in your toes. Maybe there's some tingling or numbness. Maybe you can't feel your feet at all. And if that's the case, just noticing that, that's okay. Every time we do this, we may notice different things. And as you're lying here, just allow your awareness to flow outwards, to take in everything that your body is feeling at the moment in both feet, both legs, both hands, both arms, your torso and your head. Noticing the body breathing itself, the heart beating itself, maybe thoughts come and go, just let them do that. Anytime it looks like a thought is going to take you and your attention somewhere else, just gently bring your awareness back to this breath as it flows in and then out of the body. And if there's an emotion, a memory, some anticipation of a future activity, just noticing the mind doing what the mind does and gently bringing it back again and again to your breath. If you need to, you can listen to this another time. You can just keep repeating it, or you can just gently let the track come to an end. And enjoy a restful, peaceful sleep. Sleep well.